हेलो एवरीबॉडी, आई एम डॉक्टर केशव वलसे फ्रॉम मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ वालचंद इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी सोलापुर। इन दिस सेशन विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट बेसिक्स ऑफ ज्योमेट्रिक ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस पर्टेनिंग टू कैडकैम सब्जेक्ट। पर्टिकुलरली एट द एंड ऑफ दिस सेशन viewers are expected to understand the basic concept of what is geometric transformations and in particular basic three types of transformations which are very commonly used, that is translation, scaling and rotation. To define geometric transformation, these are the operations carried out to modify the existing object, its configuration, its orientation, its shape, size, position, so as to meet the desired or required design aspects for the designer or the modeler. Now, these matrix transformations, they are carried out in different sequential orders on the objects so that ultimately from basic graphics primitives, using these transformations, combining different primitives or graphics elements with the help of these transformations, the designer can ultimately get what he wants. Let us concentrate on representation of some of the graphics features in case of two dimension, that is biaxial system. The simplest or the basic graphic element is a point. We all know, like, a point we represent in biaxial system as xy, indicating x and y coordinates of that particular point, which is a graphics element, the primitive it is also called as. Now in computer graphics, this representation is perceived as a 1 by 2 matrix. For example, if a point is represented as 2, 5. So as you all know, x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 5 in a biaxial system. But in CG, this representation is perceived as a 1 by 2 matrix. And this very basic concept of perceiving these graphics features in a matrix form is the main aspect of geometric transformations. Secondly, we will talk about another graphics element, that is line. Normally, we represent a line passing through two points as it is given here. L is equal to x1, y1, x2, y2. This is a line passing through two points. This is perceived as a 2 by 2 matrix representation. So, a point is perceived as a 1 by 2 matrix. A line is perceived as 2 by 2 matrix. Next, we'll see one more element, graphics feature. Primitive, it is also called as, that is a triangle. Triangle, we need three points. So, x1, y1, x2, y2 and x3, y3. These may be, say, for example, A, B and C, three points. Their coordinates are perceived as a 3 by 2 matrix for a triangle. Thus, any geometric transformation that we think of is fundamentally carried out on the points which are used to represent, which are used to draw that particular graphics primitive. So, basically for first time representation, what are the algorithm we are using, say for example, to represent a triangle. Same is used after points of that feature are transformed. That is a basic fundamental rule. I repeat again, points of any graphics feature are first transformed, and then with the new points, using the algorithm of representing that object is redrawn. In this session, we'll be focusing on these three very commonly used geometric transformations in case of two-dimensional representations. First is translation, second is scaling, and third is rotation. At this point, I would expect you all to just relate these discussions that we have so far made here to relate with some object. You can imagine some object or any image, and think for a while how these three transformations might be taking place. Just think for a while. Coming to first geometric transformation in case of two dimensions, that is translation. This is nothing but moving the object from one point to another point. It's repositioning, but major thing is that without altering its dimensions. We are just moving from one point to other point, repositioning, we can say. Now, if you see here, for point to be translated in biaxial system, how do we represent it mathematically? If P is the original point with the xy coordinates, and P dash is the translated point, we are talking about a point. P dash is the translated point, and T is the translation matrix, wherein Tx and Ty are given here, which are distances of a translation along x and y directions. And ultimately, we can represent the relationship for the translation of a point as P dash is equal to P plus T. I repeat, P dash is equal to P plus T. Here, note that we are adding two matrices. This is the transformation wherein we need to add two matrices. Secondly, let us talk now on scaling. In this case, we either enlarge the given object or reduce in size. Now, this enlargement or the reduction, by and large, it is equal in all the directions, in all the axes that you consider. So, circle if you consider, and if you scale it with the same scaling factor along x and y directions, it will remain circle. But conceptually, these scaling factors may be different in different directions. So again, talking about the circle, if we scale a circle with different scaling factors along x and y, it would become an ellipse. Thus, again thinking of a point, P is the original point with xy coordinates, P dash is the point after scaling, and S is the scaling matrix. This scaling matrix representation here happens to be in first row Sx and 0, then second row 0 Sy. This Sx and Sy are the scaling factors along x and y directions. Now here, this P dash we can represent as a P into S, that is coordinates of new scaled point are equal to coordinates of given original point into S, that is scaling matrix. This is a basic logic wherein we are multiplying these two matrices. In earlier case of a translation, we were adding the two matrices. Here we are multiplying two matrices in case of scaling. Now coming to third geometric transformation, that is rotation. Here, points of the object, we are rotating about the origin. This is very important. The rotation is about the origin by any given angle theta. More important point here again is, if the angle of rotation is plus theta, that is positive, then we are rotating the object in counterclockwise direction. And if this angle is negative, we are rotating this object or a point along clockwise direction. Similarly, let us think of a point in biaxial system for the rotation. P as original point, P dash as point after rotation, and R here, this R matrix is the rotation matrix, which is represented as first row cos theta sin theta and second row minus sin theta cos theta. So here again, this relationship we have, P dash is equal to P into R. Here also we are multiplying two matrices. Thus, the multiplication of these two matrices would give us the resultant matrix P dash, that is the coordinates of rotated point. Thus, in these discussions, to summarize, first transformation of translation, we are adding two matrices. Second and third, that is scaling and rotation, we are multiplying two matrices. That's what is the basic aspect of geometric transformations for these three basic types. We have referred these two books. One is CAD/CAM by M.P. Grover, and second is the CAD/CAM Mastering by Ibrahim Zaid. Thank you.